Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part three of solving compound linear inequalities, and we solve and graph these compound inequalities in this video. We're going to solve this compound linear inequality. So we have 2x minus 3 is less than 3, and 4 minus x is greater than or equal to 5. So what we're looking for are the solutions that work in both inequalities. So we'll solve one at a time here. So on the left side, let's see, we're going to add 3 to both sides. We're trying to isolate the x, so I have 2x is less than 6. And we'll divide both sides by 2. And that gives us x is less than 3. So on the left-hand side, we get x is less than 3. We're on the right-hand side. Let's see, we're trying to isolate the x. So how about if I subtract 4 first from both sides? Now be careful, this is still negative x. So I'm going to write that as negative 1x because that's what that really means. And then 5 minus 4 is 1. And now we need to multiply or divide both sides by negative 1. And remember what happens when you divide or multiply by a negative number? It switches the inequality sign. So instead of it being greater than or equal, it's actually less than or equal. So on the left-hand side, I've got just x is less than or equal, right? To negative 1. If you want, you might want to circle that so you don't forget. That's the one you're going to use. And this was and, right? So we want numbers that are less than 3 and also less than or equal to negative 1. So first of all, just think about that. What do you think the answer is going to be? You want numbers that satisfy both of those inequalities. So one way of doing it is to graph each of them. So let's graph x is less than 3. And remember what we do if we graph it, we just look at the overlap. So let's say this is 3 and that's 0, for instance. Then if I want less than 3, it's going to be the parentheses, right? Or an open circle. This goes forever, right? Keeps on going. And let's go ahead and graph x is less than or equal to negative 1. So we want to line up our numbers the same way. So here's 0 and 3. Then less than or equal to negative 1 would be here. So the overlap, if you look, is about right here and then to the left. So it's at negative 1. So the solution to this will be, now it's going, sorry, I did that wrong. The solution is actually x is less than or equal to negative 1. If you were to write that in interval notation, you would go to the left forever and ever. There's no smallest number, so we write negative infinity with a parentheses on the left. Always the smaller number on the left when you use interval notation, larger number on the right, and it goes up to a negative 1 and touches it. So that's the solution in interval notation. Now, if you were going to graph it, actually, that's the graph of the solution, right? Because it happens to be that x less than or equal to negative 1 is also the solution, even though it was just one of the pieces of the compound inequality. So here's an example, unlike the ones we've done so far, where in the end it's just a simple inequality, right? Going left or right. It wasn't in between two numbers. Like it wasn't 2 is less than x is less than or equal to 3, something like that. So you have to really think about it, or at least draw the graphs and look for the overlap. Here's our next problem. 3x is less than or equal to 0, and 2x plus 1 is greater than 3. All right, so let's solve each of these, and then again we're going to look for the overlap or where they intersect. So to solve 3x is less than or equal to 0, let's divide both sides by 3. And when you divide by a positive number, you don't switch the inequality sign. So this is x less than or equal to 0. And now let's also solve the inequality on the right. Let's see, we want to isolate the x, so we have 2x plus 1. Let's subtract 1 from both sides first. And 3 minus 1 is 2. And then we'll divide both sides by 2. So we get x is greater than 1. So in the end, we've got x is less than or equal to 0 and x is greater than 1. So think about this for a minute. Can you think of any numbers that are less than or equal to 0 and at the same time greater than 1? There are no such numbers because numbers less than 0 are negative, right? And numbers bigger than 1 are positive, and so there's no intersection there. You can graph these two to see that they are not going to have any overlap. So if this is 0 and this is 1, less than or equal to 0 looks like this, right? And then if I graph x greater than 1, it would look like this. And you can see there is absolutely no overlap, that they both have any numbers they have in common. So the solution to this is the null set. You could write it like that, or you could write no solution, or you could write braces with absolutely nothing inside of it. That shows there's also no solution. And if you were going to do a graph, you would just say there is nothing on the graph. Or you would do a graph where you don't shade anything at all to the right or the left. It's kind of confusing when you do that, though, because you're wondering, is it the whole graph or is it nothing? So usually you have to make it kind of clear that you know the answer is that there is absolutely no solution at all. So here's a problem for you to try. So put the video on pause and solve this. All right, again, it's and, so we're going to just simplify. I'm sorry, we're going to solve each inequality. So let's say on the left, I need to isolate the x. So I'm going to subtract 5 from both sides, which will give you negative 2x. Don't forget to bring down that negative sign. A lot of people forget and just write 2x. And now, to isolate the x, I need to divide both sides by negative 2. And I just divided by a negative sign, so remember, that's not going to be true anymore. It switches to the opposite direction. So my answer here will be x is greater than positive 2. All right, so when we solve the left inequality, we get x is greater than 2. Now let's do the right-hand side. So we'll divide both sides by negative 3. And here again, I divided by a negative, so I need to switch that inequality to greater than or equal. You have to do it right when you divide. You can't wait and do it on the next step. So this is x is, remember to write the greater than or equal, to negative 9 divided by negative 3 is positive 3. So I have x is greater than 2 and x is greater than or equal to 3. All right, so what numbers are going to be both bigger than 2 and also bigger than 3? All the ones bigger than 3, greater than or equal to 3, are going to be our final solution. So you can graph each of these and look at the overlap. That's one way of doing it. I like the way of just looking at it and reasoning what the answer is going to be, but we can also see it on a graph. So here we go. If I were going to do x is greater than 2, I would have this for my solution. And if I was going to do x greater than or equal to 3, I would have, this is my solution, and now I can see where the overlap is from 3 and over to the right. So that's actually the graphical solution right here. right? You can see that answer on the number line, and to write that in interval notation, it goes from 3 to infinity. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.